Hey Year 8, today for Online ITD, we are going to learn how to make a finger joint. Yes, that's right, a finger joint. The finger joint is a very common joint, and I'm sure when you guys get back to school, you'll have the chance to make one of these. Today, I'm going to make my finger joint out of these two pieces of radiata pine. I'm going to join them together like that. My finger joint's going to go right here and they will be joined together. Some tools and equipment we're going to be using today to make our finger joint. A tri-square, a tenon saw. I also have a coping saw in case I may need that as well. I have a couple of chisels. Okay, I have a 19mm chisel and also a 13mm chisel. Okay, I may need both of these as well. I have a timber mallet. I have my trusty PVA wood glue, 300mm rule, and a pencil. And I have a pair of F-clamps. Now the first thing we're wanting to do is to mark out where our finger joint is going to go. The marking out is just as important as the actual cutting away of the timber. If we don't get the marking out correct, if we don't get it accurate, it's going to mess up our joint. The joint's not going to fit together very well at all, and it's going to look pretty bad. So if we get the marking out correct, then our joint is halfway there, okay? So today, my radiator pine, it's 80 millimeters wide, so from there to there, it's 80 millimeters across. I'm going to put four fingers on each piece, okay? So four across, and it's 80 millimeters wide. That would mean that 80 divided by 4 is 20. 20, 20, 20, and 20 makes 80. Okay, all right, let's get started.
All right, so what I've done is I've placed my two pieces of radiata pine in my vise. Okay, I've made sure they're even, they're the same height. Okay, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my ruler and my pencil. As we said, it's 80 millimeters from one edge to the other edge. So we want to divide this evenly into four sections, which is 20, 20, 20, and 20. Okay, so I'm just gonna put a little mark here at 20, another mark at 40, another mark at 60 millimeters. Once I've done that, I'm going to take my tri-square. I'm just going to transfer the mark straight across on both edges, from one edge to the other edge, on each of those lines. Like this. So I've got four sections, each section is 20 millimeters long. Next thing I'm going to do, so I'm just going to take this out of the vise for now. I'm going to grab a piece and I'm just going to hold the other piece flush to the end and just place a little mark, okay, right there. We know this timber is 12 millimeters wide. I could have measured 12 millimeters, but today that's just as quick and easy. Grab my tri-square, transfer that mark all the way across. And what we need to do, once you've done that, is to transfer that line on all the way around, so across the edges and all the way on the other side. Go all the way around. Okay, so there's the line all the way around. I'll go ahead now and do the same on this piece. Thank you. Okay. So now we should have four lines on both of the pieces of our radiator pine. And from there, I'm just going to take one piece. What I'm going to do now is get my square, my tri-square. I'm just going to square these three lines, so our four sections down the face edge there. And once again, I'm going to go all the way around. Turn it over. Okay, so there's our lines transferred from the end grain down to the faces. We'll do the same for the other piece. Alright, so there we have both pieces of radiator pine have been marked out now. Okay, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4 sections 20 millimeters wide in both sections. So from there we need to mark out there with our pencil which pieces we're going to cut away. Okay, so out of this piece here we want two of the four pieces to be chopped out. Okay, so I'm just going to start on the end grain. I'm going to say, okay, I'm going to take out this one, we'll cut away that one. We'll leave that one, we'll cut that one, leave that one, and then we'll cut this one. Okay, so where I'm marking now with my lead pencil, that's the piece that I want to chop away. Okay, that one and that one. I'll just transfer that down the edges so I don't get confused. So if I'm looking at it from the side, I still know that that's the piece that I want to chop away. Turn it over. See there, those two pieces are the pieces I'm going to chop away. Now the next thing we're going to do is quite important. We don't want to chop away the exact same pieces on the other one, it's not going to fit. So the easiest way to do this now is just to line them up on the table like that, okay, end to end. I've marked these two, these are the two I want to chop away. So on the other piece, I don't want to chop away the same piece, I want to chop away the opposite piece. So I'm going to chop away this piece. And then this little piece on the end here. Okay, and then when they slide in, they'll fit, okay? So I'll just grab this one now and just mark this all the way around. And there we have it, okay? That's the mark out for our finger joints. Now it's as simple as taking our tenon saw and cutting away the pieces that we don't want. We can clean it up with the chisel, okay? So I'll go ahead and do that now. Thank you. So I've completed my finger joint. I've got a little bit of cleaning up to do just to make this one a little bit neater on here, a little bit to take out just through there. But overall, it doesn't look too bad. I'll go ahead, get it glued up, and I'll show you the finished product when it's all glued, sanded, and lacquered. Remember to like and subscribe to my channel, because I am awesome, and I shall see you next time.